You know, turn the camera off for this. This is going to give guys nightmares.
Oh, come on.
Got it. Oh,
that's about as good as it gets.
Phil McCord didn't pray for a miracle to help his golf game.
There you go.
Same result, but it looked nice.
Yeah.
But the fact he can play golf is itself a miracle.
So that was what the prayer was about. Just give me some strength. Help me get through this.
Oh, daddy-o, look at you.
I want a copy of that.
McCord worked as an engineer for the Sisters of Providence. 10 years ago, he was legally blind in his right eye and needed a cornea transplant. He wasn't even a Roman Catholic. He was raised a Baptist. But one day he was so distraught, he paused in the church, sat down, and asked Mother Theodore Guerin not for a cure, just for strength to live with whatever lay ahead, which included the possibility his eye would be lost.
The next morning, I got up and I thought, gee, my eye feels better.
Not just better, the swelling was down, way down. And though cloudy, he could see. McCord rushed to his optometrist.
He said, it is better. Oh, well, hallelujah. I said, I was going to wait and postpone the surgery and so forth. He said, no, it's better. You don't need any surgery.
This isn't something that just gets better, though, is it?
No, it never gets better. That's the point.
I'm just long for the ride. A miracle?
I will have to say my understanding is less than complete. I believe it. I feel it, but I'm an engineer. I don't know the causation. I don't know the mechanics of how that happened or how it could happen. All the doctors say, don't worry about it, because it can happen. That's why it's a miracle.
When Sister Marie Kevin learned about McCord's eye, she took the case directly to Dr. Ambrosi in Rome.
I must say that what struck me about his story was the speed of this healing. He recovered his sight in just one night.
It just sort of snowballed from there. The next thing I knew, we were in Indianapolis at a canonical trial collecting evidence for submission to Rome, which was really kind of cool. It was all translated into Italian and in this red leather book that's so somewhere deep in the bowels of the Vatican, there's a book with my name on it. So my only claim to fame.
In fact, the church did determine the healing of Phil McCord's eye was a miracle. It was the second miracle attributed to Mother Theodore Guerin. The Sisters of Providence were hopeful, but the bills were adding up. The pressure was on. It was 2005. The sisters knew they were in an era of saint-making. John Paul II himself was a saint-maker. He made the process easier, cutting down the number of miracles needed to become a saint from 3 to just 2, and allowing lay people, not just priests, to petition causes.
Credo in unum Deum.
Back in Terre Haute, Indiana, it was all coming together, 100 years of work, and a pope who could pave the way to sainthood for Mother Guerin. Then on April 2nd, 2005, Pope John Paul II died.
Did you think, oh no, oh no, we might have to start over?
Or no. Was,
you didn't have that?
No, God will provide. That's what providence is. God will provide.
2 months after John Paul died on June 5th, 2005, Dr. Andrea Ambrosi returned to the Congregation of Saints for what would be a pivotal meeting. Nearly 100 years of work, hundreds of thousands of dollars spent, and it would all come down to one vote. Ambrosi was in the hallway waiting. Even the saint maker admits he was nervous.
You had talked these nuns into spending the money, pushing the cause of Theodore, and quote, if it went badly, I would throw myself into the river. Do you remember that moment?
Yes, I remember. The sister was so worried about expenses. They worked so hard, and they didn't want to waste money on a case that might not succeed. I didn't want to give them a negative result.
The phone call would not be negative. It was, in fact, Dr. Ambrosi inviting the Sisters of Providence to Rome, to St. Peter's Square, to witness the canonization of St. Mother Theodore.
When you walked into St. Peter's Square and you looked up and you saw Mother Theodore up there? Must have been something
wonderful,
else.
Wonderful feeling to know that she was our forerunner, our model, our mother. She was a gift of God to us and to the world.
And now, a saint.